Hello YouTubers and welcome! I want to share a very quick tip for people who are just starting to use Affinity Designer or for people who are using that already but want to learn something new. Or maybe for people who want to find useful tips and tricks and improve their day-to-day drawing process. As many of you probably know, Affinity Designer is a relatively new vector, raster, hybrid design application. It also was on the winners of the 2015 Apple Design Awards, and it's still growing in popularity. And today we are going to learn how to close an open curve, and we are going to look at all possible ways to close curves in Affinity Designer, which I found while I was using this application. In the past, I was mainly drawing in Adobe Illustrator, and I built a habit to close all curves during my drawing process. In Illustrator, you can use a shortcut for it, but in Affinity Designer, it was not very obvious to find it. And after some time of my exploration and drawing in Affinity Designer, I found a couple of ways how to do it, and I want to share with you guys. Let's start! Today we are going to look at different options how to close the curve in Affinity Designer and also draw a nice gift box. Go ahead and select the pen tool on the left side, or you can hit the P key on your keyboard. And what we're going to do is we are going to draw a box, and you can see a little circle on the left side, and that means this shape will close automatically. Let's click on it and move it to make sure it's closed. Select pen tool again. Let's draw a lid for this box. Something like that. Select Node tool or hit E key on your keyboard, and let's move that we have created. As you can see, the shape hasn't closed properly and our stroke just cut over here. We are going ahead and move to the top bar until we find closed curve. Just hit it and that shape is closed now. But as you can see, two dots are still there. Let's delete it to keep this art clear. Let's move on and let's have a look at another version how to close the curve in Affinity Designer. Go ahead and choose a pen tool or you can hit the P key. Draw a line. Here we are going to create a ribbon on our gift box, but a little bit different as we did before. Select Move tool or press V on your keyboard and let's copy and paste this line and flip horizontal. Now you can see that now we have two separate lines. Select both of them and let's move to the top bar until we find joint curve. Just hit it. Now we can see that just one path is closed. Please keep in mind that the closest points will always be closed. To see what I mean by that, let's redo that and move those lines and just see what will happen when we will hit join curve again. Now you can see that the closest point are closed again. Now you go to the top and press close curve as we did before. You can move around to make sure that all curves are closed. Now you learn another way how to do that. Now go ahead and have a look at another way how we can close curves in Affinity Designer. Let's say we want to draw a decoration on our box, but at the same time to do that faster and again with closed curves. Go to the left bar and select a brush tool or press B key on your keyboard. And let's draw some circles over here and here. As you can see, all my circles now have an open curve.
But don't worry, just let's go ahead and choose Move tool and select a box and let's copy and paste. You can do it just pressing Command C and Command V for Mac or Control C and Control V for Windows. Now we are going to select a box and all our circles. Go to the top and on the right corner you will find Divide over here. Just hit it. And now you can see all our pieces are split and have closed curves. Nice! Now let's delete pieces that we don't need. And let's select the Node tool and move that curve to make sure that it is closed. And basically that's it. I hope you guys like it and learn something new. To be honest, I haven't found shortcuts for a quick closing curve in Affinity Designer. Even if I tried to set up my vacuum, but without any luck as well. Anyway, if you have any question or suggestion, please just leave them in the comments and I will try to find the answer for you. Or create another tutorial for you. If you like this video, don't be shy, press thumbs up. And please subscribe, do not miss other tutorials. And see you soon!